Good evening. Queensland is facing testing times. More than 1,500 new cases today. And as the virus infects the state, testing rules are changing. All travellers will need now is a rapid DIY test to cross the border. The catch is they're hard to come by. And the plan's all based on trusting that every person's doing the right thing.
These are the little testing kits set to ease the COVID burden if you can get hold of them.
Rapid antigen testing was an appropriate form of testing in the current environment.
With testing queues spiralling across the country, inbound travellers will soon be able to use these as proof they don't have COVID. From Saturday, instead of waiting for a negative PCR test, only a negative DIY rapid antigen test is required.
It is an honesty system, but it is to make a false declaration is a criminal offence.
But still, the virus is getting into Queensland and spreading to all areas across the state. Now a case has been reported as far north as the Torres Strait.
They'd recently travelled to Sydney, so that's the most likely source.
Another 1,589 cases were detected out of 30,000 tests. 8 are being treated in hospital. With so many cases, contact tracers aren't able to keep up. Not all exposure venues are being listed because it's so widespread.
As this pandemic develops and advances, it has always been the intention to slowly pull back, carefully pull back, all of our public health measures.
Around 90% double dose, which we're getting very close to. Once we hit 90%, you don't need any test.
Even still, every day, more people are lining up to make sure they're not spreading the virus.
The Chief Health Officer says more changes are likely in the coming weeks with all things on the table, like redefining close contact and other testing regimes.
The tourism sector says the move to ease tough testing restrictions was a long time coming.
It's going to mean those wishing to travel to Queensland can do so significantly easier, but importantly take the pressure off those health systems in other states.
We are starting to see from all parts of the state businesses that are going into hibernation at what should be their busiest time of the year.
There's no stopping the wave, but at least now there's been time to prepare.
And Andrew, tonight we can reveal there is a rush on rapid antigen tests. Nine News has been told the state government has written to the federal government calling on it to release some of its national stockpile of the tests. That's because the state government's become aware that some of the retail stocks of these kits won't be replenished until the second week of January. And Andrew, ahead tonight we'll take a closer look at rapid antigen testing, how it's going to shape everyday life, how to use them and how to get your hands on them.
Yeah, we're looking forward to that, Josh. Thank you.